Good morning, brothers and sisters.
弟兄姊妹们早，早上好。
And also Happy New Year.
也新年快乐。
We just want to thank the Lord for the songs that we just sung.
我感谢主有刚才我们唱的这么美好的诗歌。
And when we come and break bread together,
当我们一起来擘饼的时候，
We can really enjoy the blessings that the Lord has done for us.
我们实在是享受神所赐给我们各样的祝福。
As Christians, more than anything, and wishing other people Happy New Year.
在我们作为一个基督徒，不仅仅是祝福别人新年快乐。
As Paul says, we have a Savior who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ.
像保罗所说的，他在基督里已经赐给我们各样天上属灵的各样的福气。
This morning, I would like to share with brothers and sisters on Luke 15.
今天早上，我和弟兄姊妹们要分享的是路加福音十五章。
The Gospel of Luke has a very specific theme of Jesus as the Son of Man.
路加福音十五章实在有一个主题，就是我们的主耶稣作为人子。
And in Luke 19, verse 10, Jesus states that the purpose he came to the earth was to seek and to save that which was lost.
在路加福音十九章中，我们主耶稣讲，他来到世上是为了寻找拯救世上的人。
And if we ask each other how we have met the Lord Jesus, each one of us has a wonderful story to tell.
如果我们彼此来问我们如何来信主的，我们每一个人都有那美好的一个见证。
And it's the story of the grace and mercy that the Lord has given to us.
实在主给我们在我们的身上有何等的恩典和怜悯。
And that is the gospel, the good news.
这就是福音那个好消息。
And that is the blessing above all blessings.
这是在所有祝福之上最美的祝福。
Today we want to meditate on this idea of being lost and found.
今天我们就来思想这个想法这个观点，说是丧失了又寻见了。
And not only that, but the value of the lost and found.
并且我们来思想如何我们丢失又寻见它的价值是什么。
And Jesus' willingness to save people like us.
我们主耶稣是如何他心甘情愿的来拯救我们。
Will you turn with me to Luke chapter 15?
我们来看路加福音十五章。
And we'll get our brother to read in Chinese, verses 1 to 10.
我来用中文读第一节到第十节，弟兄会后面用英文他来读。第一节，众税吏和罪人都挨近耶稣，要听他讲道。法利赛人和文士私下议论说，这个人接待罪人，又同他们吃饭。耶稣就用比喻说，你们中间虽有一百只羊，失去一只，不把这九十九只撇在旷野，去找那失去的羊，直到找着呢。找着了，就欢欢喜喜地扛在肩上回到家里，就请朋友邻舍来，对他们说：“我失去的羊已经找着了，你们和我一同欢喜吧。”我告诉你们，一个罪人悔改，在天上也要这样为他欢喜，脚比为99个不用悔改的义人欢喜更大。或是一个富人有十块钱，若失落一块，岂不点上灯，打扫屋子，细细地找，直到找着吗？找着了，就请朋友邻舍来，对他们说：“我失落的那块钱已经找着了，你们和我一同欢喜吧。”我告诉你们，一个罪人悔改，在他的使者面前也是这样为他欢喜。
Verse 11. Then he said, A certain man had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that fall to me. So he divided to them his livelihood. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together, journeyed to a far country, and there wasted his possessions with prodigal living. But when he had spent all, there arose a severe famine in that land, and he began to be in want. Then he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into the fields to feed swine. And he would gladly have filled his stomach with the pods that the swine ate, but no one gave him anything. But when he came to himself, he said, How many of my father's hired servants have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger. I will arise and go to my father and say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you, and I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants. And he arose and came to his father, but when he was still a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in your sight, and I am no longer worthy to be called your son. But the father said to his servants, Bring out the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and the sandals on his feet, and bring the fatted calf here and kill it, and let us eat and be merry. For this is my son, was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found, and they began to be merry. Now his older son was in the field, and as he came and drew near to the house, he heard music and dancing. He called one of the servants and asked him what these things meant. And he said to him, your brother has come, and because he has received him safe and sound, your father has killed the fatted calf. But he was angry and would not go in. Therefore his father came out and pleaded with him. So he answered and said to his father, lo, these many years I have been serving you. I never transgressed your commandment at any time, and yet you never gave me a young goat that I might make merry with my friends. But as soon as the son of yours came, who has devoured your livelihoods with harlots, you killed the fatted calf for him. And he said to him, son, you are always with me, and all that I have is yours. It was right that we should make merry and be glad, for your brother was dead and is alive again, and was lost and is found. And these parables are all the same, I feel.
所有的这个三个比喻其实都是一样的。
They talk about the same things.
他们讲到同样一件事。
There are three lost things and three found things.
三个丢失的东西，三个寻回来。
But they all also talk about the heart of our Heavenly Father.
他也是讲到我们天父的心。
And the willingness of Jesus to seek us out.
讲到我们的主耶稣，他如何的愿意来寻找我们。
And they also speak about what is valuable in the sight of God.
在我们神的眼中，这是如何的宝贵。
So let's look at each parable and see what the Lord has for us in His Word.
让我们来一个一个看这个比喻，来看神要对我们讲什么样的话。
These three parables were a response to Jesus receiving sinners and eating with them.
这个比喻的背景就是我们主耶稣接受罪人与他们一同来用餐。
The scribes and the Pharisees complained about Jesus.
当然，文士和法利赛人他们就抱怨。
And Jesus, in response, gave three parables.
我们主耶稣就回应他们，用这三个比喻来回应。
And Jesus was eating with tax collectors and sinners.
主耶稣与这些税吏和罪人来一同来用餐。
And so Jesus gave the people these three parables.
所以我们的主耶稣就给他们讲这三个比喻。
In the first parable, we have a shepherd who loses a sheep from his fold.
我第一个比喻讲到有一个牧人他在他羊群中间丢失了一只羊。
And I think we understand what this parable means if we have ever owned something.
如果我们曾经拥有过任何的东西，我们知道这意味着什么。
But it has gone missing.
它丢失了。
Who has not lost maybe wallet or keys or your smartphone?
我们每个人可能都丢过钱包或者钥匙或者是现在的手机。
In the case of the lost sheep, we don't know exactly how that one sheep ended up away from the flock.
当这只丢失的羊的时候，我们不知道为什么这个羊会丢失了。
It probably wandered away innocently.
或者它无知的就那么走开了。
Maybe it got distracted by food.
或者它被某个食物所吸引。or
saw something and walked toward it.
或者它好奇看到一些东西，它就走向那个东西。
And all of a sudden, without knowing or understanding, the sheep was lost.
他自己好像都不知道的时候，他就丢失了。
And isn't that how we get lost?
是不是这样，我们也是往往这样来迷失呢？
We are unaware or ignorant of things going around us.
我们不意识到我们周围的情景，或者是我们根本不理解周围的情景。
And the phrase, before you know it, comes to mind.
在我们之前，在这个观念来到我们心里之前。
And before you know it, your environment becomes unfamiliar.
这个环境好像我们非常不熟悉。
You only hear your own voice.
我们只听到自己的声音。
And before you know it, the shepherd is out of sight.
而且我们只有知道的是这个牧人好像看不见。
So the good shepherd will leave the flock of the 99 sheep in the wilderness for this one sheep.
但是那个好牧人把那99只羊就撇在旷野去寻找这一只迷失的羊。
Now some say this is a good parable, but it's not a very smart or a wise one.
有人讲这是一个很好的比喻，但不是一个很聪明的一个做法。
It's great that the shepherd found the sheep, but it could have ended really badly.
很好，我们这个牧人找到了这只羊，可能但是也许会有一个非常不好的结局。
Leaving the flock in the wilderness is risky.
把这个羊群就撇在旷野，实在是一件危险的事情。
We don't know what time of day it was. It could have been dark, and the flock could have been at risk.
我们不知道这个是在一天的什么时候，或许是在黑暗的当中，这个羊群就在危险的当中。
There might have been thieves or robbers looking to steal these sheep.
或者是有强盗或者是贼要来把这些羊偷走了。
They could have been taken by a pack of wolves.
或者是有一群狼来攻击了这个羊群。
Surely these 99 sheep are more valuable than just one.
当然那99只羊比那一只�ang更有价值。
And one out of 100 is only 1%.
一只羊在一百只羊中的一只羊只是百分之一。
The rational thing to do, the reasonable thing, is to just cut your losses.
好像比较合理的事情，要做的事情，好像就是我们要就避免这个损失。
But our shepherd is not like that at all.
但是我们的牧人不是这样子的。
When he has found his sheep, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing.
当他找到的这只羊，他就欢欢喜喜地扛在肩上。
Finding that one sheep was worth it.
好像找到的这只羊所有配就值，所有的都值了。
Why is that?
为什么呢？
Because they all belong to him.
因为所有的这羊都是属他的。
He is the shepherd, and he's not a hired hand.
他是牧羊，牧羊人，他不是高高在上的那位。
The fact that the shepherd would leave the 99 sheep and go after that one sheep is proof that each animal was dear to him.
因为他牧人舍一舍弃那九十九只羊，为了那一只羊来寻找，就证明他是爱他们。
Who are the sheep that belong to the Lord?
谁是属羊属神的羊呢？
All are the Lord's.
我们所有的属神的。
In Psalm 24:1, it says, "The earth is the Lord's, and all its fullness, the world and all who dwell therein."
诗篇的二十四篇的第一节里面讲，地和其中所充满的，世界和住在其间的，都属耶和华。
For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son.
神爱世人，把他独生的爱子是为我们舍。
That all men be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth.
所以让我们所有万人能够得救，也应该因此明白真道。
Jesus didn't come on this earth only for the famous.
主耶稣来到这个世上不是为了一个出名。
Or maybe those with status.
好像某一个地位。
Or maybe those that are morally upright.
好像说道德上自己是如何的正确。
Was there a time when we were lost?
当我们在迷失的时候。
When we didn't know who God was?
当我们不认识神是谁的时候
，When we were satisfied with our own thinking and our own ways of doing things，
当我们满足于我们自己的想法、我们自己做事的方式的时候
，When we were content to live in sin and be our own masters，
当我们满足于活在罪中成为我们自己主人的时候
，We were living contrary to the will of God，
我们就和主所愿意我们所活的样子活成了相反的样子。
In Isaiah 53 verse 6 it says。
在以赛亚书五十三章第六节中讲
，All we like sheep have gone astray，
我们都如羊走迷，个人偏行己路。
We've all turned every one to his own way，
所以我们每个人都偏行己路。
And yet the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all，
耶和华使我们的众人的罪都归在他身上。
By the grace and mercy of our Lord he found us，
但是主的恩典他寻找到了我们。
We were wandering from the fold and He returned with us.
我们离开了这个羊圈，但是他来寻找我们。
We have a hymn in our hymnary, 195, that says, "Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger, interposed his precious blood."
我们诗歌本里面的195首里面，来啊，你这万福的泉源中。写道我们耶稣我本外人任意流荡基督却亲来循环因着救我脱离死亡竟然血溅加略山
Isn't this the beginning of all our journeys with Jesus?
这是不是我们与我们主耶稣一起的旅程的一个开始
Jesus found us and brought us back to himself
主耶稣找到了我们把我们带到他的身边
We were lost when we weren't in the place where we belong
我们迷失了，在一个我们不属于我们的地方。
Because we belong to the fold of God.
因为我们属神的羊圈。
To win us back and to rescue us, he had to pay with his precious blood.
把我们拯救回来，他必须付那个沉重的代价。
He sacrificed himself on the cross to seek and to save us.
他在十字架上为我们流血舍命，寻找我们，来拯救我们。
And every time when we break bread together,
当每一次我们擘饼的时候
we are reminded of these things.
我们就提醒我们这件事。
I want those that have gospel friends to be also encouraged by this parable as well.
当我们有福音朋友的时候，我们也鼓励我们弟兄要用这个比喻来跟福音朋友们讲。
Because this parable is not just about the sheep, but the good shepherd.
这个因为这个比喻不仅仅讲到这个羊，更多的是讲到那个好牧人。
Maybe the Lord is seeking these friends through your love and prayers and invitations.
也许我们主耶稣就找到你的朋友通过这个爱通过这个寻找
He is seeking them out and will rejoice in heaven when he finds them
因为我们找到一个在天上就有何等大的欢喜
Just like heaven rejoiced when you were found.
就像当你被寻找的时候，天上是如何的欢喜。
If you have been praying for friends and family, I want to remind you that they can also be that lost sheep of the Lord's.
如果你没有为你的朋友们祷告的，我们提醒你，因为他们也是那个迷失的羊。
And you are given the opportunity to bring them to the Lord.
因为你神把这个机会交给你，让你们把他们带到神的面前。
In the second parable, we read about a woman who has lost one of her 10 coins.
第二个比喻里面讲到一个妇人，她丢失了10块钱中的一块钱。
In context, women at that time would string up 10 of these coins.
背景是这个妇人有十块钱。
And sometimes in a necklace or a garland to wear.
或者是在她的这个项链上，或者是在她一个环这个戴的环上面的丢失了一块。
And it was a sign of being a married woman.
好像这个表示她是一个已经结婚了的妇人。
And one day this woman noticed that one of her coins was missing.
当这个妇人注意到她有一块钱已经丢失了。
And so she lights a lamp to get a better look inside her house.
她就把这个灯点亮，要在房间里面来找。
She sweeps the house and carefully searches until it is found.
她打扫屋子，细细地找，直到找着。
When we misplace things, we always look for them in the last place we thought we put them.
当我们丢失一件东西的时候，我们永远是在我们刚刚最后放的地方，我们来寻找。
We think that I clearly put it down over there, and now it's gone.
我们常常会觉得，我们好像很清楚的就放在那里，但是现在没了。
And we think, well, did it grow legs and walk away?
是不是这个东西长了腿跑了？
And we ask somebody, maybe a family member, if they have seen it.
我们问我们的家里面的成员说，你们看没看到？
We feel so uneasy or we have anxiety when we don't find it immediately.
我们如果没有马上找到，我们就会感到不舒服，甚至很焦虑。
Why is that?
为什么呢？
It's because the thing that's missing.
因为那个丢失的那件东西。
Your wallet or your keys or your phone.
不管是钱包，你的钥匙或者你的手机。
Has value to you.
对你来说是有价值的。
The time spent searching and investigating is worth it because your possession is lost.
你所花在寻找上面投资的时间是值得的，因为你这个是你所拥有的东西，它丢失了。
In the same way, this woman searched very hard because the coin was very valuable to her.
同样的，这个妇人要努力的寻找，因为这一枚钱对她来说是非常的有价值。
Like the shepherd in the first parable, she went and searched for that which was missing.
就像第一个比喻里面所讲的，这个牧人就讲那个来寻找那个迷失的那只羊。
She lit a lamp to search the house.
这个妇人就点上了灯来寻找，在房间里面寻找。
Probably her search carried on into the night.
或者是她寻找的时候一直到深夜的里面。
And in those days, houses weren't brightly lit at night.
那个时候在房间里面可能就光线不太好。
Most likely it would have a single door or window.
或者是只有一个门一扇窗。
And she would light this costly oil and spend time looking for this coin with a lamp.
她宁可用这个昂贵的油来点亮这个灯，来寻找这枚丢失的钱。
And then she would sweep and search carefully.
她打扫这个屋子，她细细的寻找。
And in those times, the floor is not like what we have now.
那个年代，他们所有的房间的地不和我们现在不一样。
It's not made of stone or tile.
不是用石头的，或者是瓷砖的。
They didn't have hardwood or carpet.
或者是硬木地板，或者是地毯。
The floor would be made by packing the earth and covering it with dried reeds.
那个时候是用那个泥土打实了，之后上面铺上这个苇草、芦苇。
And now you can imagine losing a coin in the dark.
我们可以想象，在那种情况下，在黑暗中丢失了一枚硬币。
And in a house with that kind of floor, what a difficult task it would be to find that coin.
在那种的地上来寻找这枚丢失的钱币是如何的困难。
And now some might say it's only a coin.
或者有人会说只是一枚钱币。
That's only 1/10 of this necklace.
这只是你的项链中间的十分之一。
If this woman wore her jewelry outside the next day with only 9 coins, who would really know?
即使这个妇人第二天仍然把这个项链带出去。有九个钱币在上面，谁会注意呢？
It's only 10%.
只是十分之一。
Actually, it's probably less than 10% of all the wealth that she owned.
或者是在对她来所有的财富来讲，这远远的要少于十分之一。
Surely it's not worth staying up and sweeping and losing sleep over.
可能根本就不值得你好像不睡觉来一直来打扫来寻找。
Maybe it's best to sleep on it and start searching again tomorrow.
或者是就干脆就在上面 睡觉、之后第二天再来寻找。
Some might say that the woman was foolish.
或许有人会讲这个妇人实在是愚蠢。
After all, was it really lost?
总体来说，即使这个钱真的丢失了吗？
It was still inside the house.
它仍然在这个房间的里面。
Why bother searching for it at all if it would just show up eventually?
你为什么要去寻找呢？因为最终在某个时候它就会出现的。
But for this woman, she knew what was missing, and it was important that she found it right away.
因为这个妇人知道她所丢失的是什么，而且非常对她来说非常重要，她要马上来寻找，能够得到这枚硬币。
She wasted no time and persevered, and she found that missing coin.
她马上就行动，她耐心地来寻找这枚丢失的钱币。
And there was rejoicing with her friends and neighbors.
她找到了，就与这个邻居们、邻舍们来一起欢喜快乐。
Brothers and sisters, if we like sheep have been found by Jesus,
如果我们像他一样，我们被主耶稣所寻见了
，and belong in the fold of God, then we are in His house.
我们再次回到他的圈中，我们属于他的家。
Paul states in 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 19 to 21.
保罗在提摩太后书二章19-21节中间讲
，Nevertheless, the solid foundation of God stands, having the seal.The Lord knows those who are His, and let everyone who names the name of Christ depart from iniquity.
第十九节，然而神坚固的根基立住了，上面有这印记说，主认识谁是他的人，又说，凡称呼主名的人，总要离开不义。
But in a great house there are not only vessels of gold and silver, but also of wood and clay, some for honor and some for dishonor.
在大户人家不但有金器银器，也有木器瓦器，有作为贵重的，有作为卑贱的。
Therefore, if anyone cleanses himself from the latter, he will be a vessel for honor, sanctified, and useful for the master, prepared for every good work.
人若自洁，脱离卑贱的事，就必做贵重的器皿，成为圣洁，合乎主用，预备行各样的善事。
Thank the Lord that in His house there are many people.
感谢主，在他的家里面有很多人。
From every tribe and every nation.
有各族各方的人。
He has saved us all.
他把我们都拯救了。
But also in his house today, there are those who are lost in the darkness.
但是在今天，在神的家里，仍然有迷失在黑暗中间的。
Those in sin that need repentance.
真的有在罪中需要悔改。
And how much he wants to seek us out.
真的是我们的主是何等的希望能够寻找我们。
It says, "Let everyone who names the name of Christ depart from iniquity."
这他们特别的讲，所有的我们所有的罪孽。我们所有的罪孽都归在他身上。
Are we tolerating sin?
我们允许这个罪在我们的身上吗？
Let us examine and cleanse ourselves.
让我们自己来够检查自省，能够成为圣洁。
There is a reason that Jesus likens these two parables to a sinner who repents.
为什么讲这个两个比喻？因为我们主对我们所有的罪人都有一个悔改的一个心意。
He has saved us from the kingdom of darkness and
他救我们脱离那黑暗的权势
and translated us into the kingdom of the Son of His love.
把我们迁到他爱子的国度里面
And God is looking for vessels for honor and not for dishonor.
他让我们成为那个贵重的器皿，而不是作为那个卑贱的器皿。
We belong in this great house of God.
我们属于这个主这个大的一个家里面。
And yet sometimes we can also be hidden or covered.
很多时候可能我们是隐藏的或者是被遮盖的。
We can be hidden in the multitudes of the people that are in the Lord's house.
我们可以在神的家里面众人中间我们就隐藏在其中。
If we look around, do we know the brothers and sisters that are sitting in the pews next to us?
我们左右看的时候我们认识在我们长椅上左右坐在我们身边的弟兄姊妹。
And it's so easy for us to blend in and say our hellos on Sundays.
在主日的时候我们很容易对着弟兄姊妹说你好之后我们就好像混在其中了。
Or we hide and wait until the louder brothers or sisters have prayed and shared before we speak up.
我们或者是我们躲藏我们等着那个大声音的弟兄姊妹们他们先讲话。
Maybe we walk in and out of weekly meetings, taking for granted the opportunities we have to gather together.
我们每天来到聚会的当中可能我们不以为然。
And oftentimes I think, yes, I belong to VCA.
很多时候我们也许我们觉得我们自己属于温哥华基督教会。
And the reality is that we are disappearing into this earthen floor.
但是现实是就像那个比喻里面所讲的，我们就消失在那个泥土的地上。
We're being buried underneath the dry reeds.
就在那个干草，藏在那个干草的下面。
Are we like that coin that is lost but inside this house?
我们是不是就像那个硬币，就丢失在那个干在这个干草的里面
？Because we can still be in this house but hidden.
但是我们可以好像仍然在这个房间的里面，但是我们是隐藏的。
For example, I have a set of plates and bowls at home.
比如说我在家里有一套的碗和盘子。
And I probably haven't used it in a year.
或者是大约有一年的时间我们没有用到。
And there's nothing really wrong with a set of plates and bowls.
在这个这一套的碗和盘没有任何的问题。
It's not broken.
也没有破了。
It can hold food just the same as any other.
它可以来盛食物，就像其他的碗盘一样。
But they are actually hidden from view.
但是它们就隐藏，好像我们看不见它。
They sit in the back of a cupboard.
它在这个橱柜的后面。
And I don't really think about it.
我好像真的是都不想到这一套碗盘。
In English, we have a phrase, out of sight, out of mind.
在英文里讲，中文里也有，眼不见心不烦。
When we prepare meals, we take the bowls and plates from the front of the cupboard.
当我们准备晚餐的时候，我们就从那个橱柜里面把前面的碗和盘拿下来用。
It's only recently, though, that we've thought about that set of plates and bowls that sit in the back.
我们最近呢，我们就想到的后面的那一套碗盘。
And what is that thought that we've had?
我们的想法是什么呢？
The thought is that we don't use them.
我们想，我们既然不用它。
We need to replace them to make room for something more useful.
我们就把它给替代了，用放了一些更有用的东西在那里。
A vessel that is not useful is not an honorable vessel.
如果一个器皿它不被用的话，那么它就不是贵重的器皿。
A useful vessel is not one that only sits on the shelf.
如果是一个有用的器皿，不是只是放在架子上的那个器皿。
But one that the master uses.
而是它的主人要使用的器皿。
One that is prepared for every good work.
而是为了行各样善事的器皿。
We need to be vessels of honor and prepared for every good work.
我们要做那个贵重的器皿，来预备我们来行各样的善事。
Because the very definition of a vessel is to contain or to carry something.
我们所有的器皿的定义就是我们来包含、来承载某一些东西。
What good is a vessel if it doesn't fulfill its purpose?
如果一个器皿不能完成这样的使命的话，它有什么用呢？
This lost coin still retained its value, but it was taken out of circulation.
这个丢失的钱币仍然有价值，但是它不能够进到一个循环的里面。
And a hidden coin is as good as a lost coin.
好像一个隐藏的硬币，就像那个丢失的硬币是一样的。
It couldn't be used by the woman until it was found in her hands.
它不能够被这个妇人所用，直到她找到了，放在她的手中。
Brothers and sisters, we need to come into His house and be prepared to be used by God.
我们弟兄姊妹们，我们来到这个神的家，我们就要预备我们自己被主所用。
We need to be ready to participate in our meetings.
我们要做好预备来参与我们各样的聚会。
Whether it's when we break bread together or listen or read God's word.
我们很多时候可能是在擘饼的里面，或者是我们在听主的话语的时候。
Or maybe when we pray together or fellowship in Bible study.
我们可以一起祷告的时候，或者我们在这个读经分享的时候。
Or when we care for one another and demonstrate the love of God.
我们能够彼此的关心，能够彰显神的爱。
Otherwise, what good is it to come into God's house once or twice a week and leave?
否则的话，我们每一周一两次来到神的家有什么益处呢？
In the parable of the talents, the master is not pleased if we are buried in the ground.
是这个比喻里面所讲的，当我们如果被好像迷失在地上了这个主人就不会得到满足。
Brothers and sisters, we cannot be hidden in the house of God.
弟兄姊妹们，我们在神的家里面不要成为那个隐藏的。
We pray that the Holy Spirit and His Word can illuminate us and shine around us.
我们祷告让神的灵能够照亮我们，能够在我们周围照亮我们。
To reveal our true condition before Him.
让我们在明白我们自己在他面前真实的光景。
And thank God we only need a little light to be found.
感谢主，我们只需要一点点的光，我们就被寻见了。
It only takes a little bit of light to see a small, shiny, metallic object.
如果要寻找一个金属的物件，只要一点点的光就能够寻见。
Today, our good shepherd may be seeking us out.
今天我们可能是一个好牧人在寻找我们。
We don't know how long it will take, but he is seeking us out until he finds us.
我们不知道要多长的时间，但是他一直在寻找，一直到找到我们。
Like searching for that lost coin, which is lost in darkness.
就像那个迷失在黑暗中的钱币一样。
Or even a hidden coin.
或者是那个隐藏的钱币。
Our Lord has one goal in mind.
我们的主在他心里面只有一个目的。
And that he will seek and save those that are lost.
他是来到寻找，来拯救那些迷失的。
The third and familiar parable is often titled the Prodigal Son.
我们第三个比喻就是那个有名的比喻，浪子的回头的故事。
Prodigal meaning somebody who is wasteful or recklessly spends money.
浪子就是说很浪费，或者是他毫无顾忌来花金钱。
And this parable is also about a lost son and a father who is waiting for him to return.
但是这个浪子的比喻，它不仅是讲的是这个浪子已经迷失了，而是讲他的父亲在等待着他。
There is a son that wants nothing to do with his father.
这个有个儿子，他不想与他父亲有任何的关系。
He just wants his inheritance, and when he gets it, he journeys to a faraway country and squanders his possessions in prodigal living.
他只是要得父亲的家业，之后他准备就到远方去，做这个过这个浪荡的生活。
And then a famine comes, and the son has to deal with the consequences of his past choices and actions.
但是这个结果就是他为着他所付出的所有的行为，他有一个代价。
He becomes in want.
他就有一个需要了。
He suffers poverty and hunger.
他就成为贫穷，他就挨饿了。
And we don't know how long it was until he came to this realization.
都不知道他经历了多长时间这件事情，直到他意识到。
He said to himself, "How many of my father's hired servants have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger? I will arise and go to my father, and will say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you, and I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants.'"
所以他想，我父亲有多少的雇工，口粮有余，我倒在这里饿死吗？我要起来到我父亲那里去，向他说：“父亲，我得罪了天，又得罪了你。从今以后，我不配称为你的儿子，把我当作一个雇工吧。”
What a sad parable it would be if the son were to stay in that faraway land.
如果这个比喻只是这个浪子在那个远远的地方离开他的父亲，是这个比喻是多么的悲惨。
He would be living in despair and regret for the rest of his life.
真的是他就。生活在这贫穷的里面，他在余生里面一直生活在这个痛苦的当中。
And then the story would have ended there, the son just starving in a foreign land and eventually dying there.
那如果比喻是这样的话，这个浪子就最终结局在那里，他在远方的地方都饿死。
But he humbled himself, arose and went back to his father.
但是他自己谦卑，他就起来回到他父亲那里。
Luke 15 says that when he was still a great way off,His father saw him and had compassion, and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him.
第路加福音里特别讲，当他起来往父亲那里去的时候，相距还远，他父亲看见就动了慈心，跑去抱着他的颈项，连连与他亲嘴。
We can see the love and compassion of the father.
我们可以看到神这个父亲的爱和父亲对他的感情。
And this is the love and compassion that the father has for his son.
这是一个父亲对他儿子的感情和爱。
It's the son that wanted nothing to do with him.
这个儿子是好像要与他毫无关系的这样的一个儿子。
This was before any words were exchanged.
这是在他们之间有任何的话语交流之前发生的事情。
The son didn't even get a chance to offer to be a servant or a slave.
这个儿子根本没有机会像他自己所想的，我要做一个雇工。
If I were in the father's shoes,
我如果假设我站在这个父亲的位置。
I would have been so happy that this son would have came and apologized to me.
我将非常的，如果我的儿子能够站在我的面前向我来道歉，我会非常的高兴。
And I would have gotten a new slave.
那而且我们讲，我又有一个新的雇工了。
But the son said to the father, "Father, I have sinned against heaven and in your sight, and I am no longer worthy to be called your son."
但是他儿子讲，我父亲，我得罪了天，又得罪了你，我不配成为你的儿子。
Did he really think that he was no longer a son and in the position of a servant?
真的是他不认为他是不再是这个儿子的位置，而是在这个雇工的位置吗？
His thinking of himself had taken a complete U-turn.
他的所有的想法完全的有一个180度的转变。
At the beginning, he thought he was deserving of his share of the inheritance.
在开始的时候，他认为他有权利来享受他父亲的遗产。 他今天的产业。
And now he was saying that he was not worthy to be called a son.
但是他现在认为他，我不配做你的儿子。
Brothers and sisters, what is our worth?
弟兄姊妹们，我们的价值在哪里？
What is the value of a human being?
我们人的价值在哪里？
There seems to be two prevailing thoughts in the world.
在世界上有两个主流的想法。
That mankind is worth either very much or very little.
人的价值或者多，或多或少。
And I find that society judges us on the worth of somebody by three things.
我们的社区来评论我们每个人是用这三件事来评论我们的。
Behavior and achievements.
我们的行为，我们获得了什么样的一个成绩。
Or human potential and future accomplishments.
或者是你的潜在的价值，你将来的所能够拿到的成绩。
Or our inherent value.
或者是我们内在的一个价值。
Which one is it?
哪一个呢？
Is mankind valuable, or are we not worth very much at all?
如果按照人的标准来说，我们好像不值什么。
How can we judge ourselves rightly and not use our own thinking to see ourselves?
如果我们这样的话，如何我们来评估自己，来看到我们自己的真相？
We know that this world has a different value system than us.
我们知道这个世界有不同的价值系统。
And do we use that as a basis for our decisions in life?
这就是我们在这个价值系统的基础上，我们来做我们人生的决定。
We turn to Scripture for God's point of view.
我们来看经文，来看神的观点是什么。
The psalmist in Psalm 8:3-4 says, "When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have ordained, what is man that you are mindful of him, and the son of man that you visit him?"
诗篇第八篇的三节到第四节，我观看你指头所造的天，并你所陈设的月亮星宿，便说人算什么，你竟顾念他；世人算什么，你竟眷顾他。
Compared to the creation and the work of God's hands, who are we really?
从神的创造和他的工作来讲，我们算什么呢？
What do we really have?
我们有什么呢？
What have we really done?
我们做了什么呢？
We are nothing.
我们什么都不是。
So which son are we?
我们是哪一个儿子呢？
Are we like the younger son whose value system was based on material wealth and possessions?
我们是那个弟弟年幼的儿子他的所有的价值是看着这个物质的因素，他有多少的一个产业。
He wanted his inheritance to experience the pleasures of the world.
他要他自己的所应有的那一份他可以享受世上的快乐。
He also recognized that his father's servants had enough food to spare.
但是他也同时认识到他的父亲有很多的雇工而且恐聊有余。
The older son, on the other hand, placed his achievements and merits on his moral standing as something to boast about.
他的大的儿子当然如果按照道德的观念他所取得的成绩实在他又可以自己自夸的地方。
He had been obedient and served diligently.
他非常的顺服而且他殷勤的服侍。
And we understand what the older brother is thinking.
我们明白他这个兄大的儿子他所想的是什么。
It doesn't make sense that the father would welcome back somebody who has squandered his inheritance.
我们想这个大儿子的心中一定认为他这个父亲如何对待这样的一个浪费他的产业的小儿子是不当的。
You know, this father had two sons.
因为这个父亲有两个儿子。
And when one left, he still had 50% of his children.
他一个儿子走开了，他还有一半50%的儿子。
And it was the better son too.
而且这个儿子更好。
The son that served the father and never transgressed his commandments.
而且这个儿子服侍父亲，从来不去惹怒他。
This father should have waited and welcomed this broken, dirty guy back.
但是这个父亲等待着这个已经完全的满身污秽已经完全毫无价值的儿子能够返回来。
But now this prodigal son returned, and he's given the best robe.
当这个小儿子回来的时候，他们把最好的袍子给他预备。
A ring on his finger.
把他戒指戴在他的指头上。
Sandals on his feet.
把鞋也穿在他脚上。
A feast is prepared and the fatted calf is killed.
在那个里面，他就预备了宴席，把一个肥牛犊宰了。
It doesn't make sense to us.
对我们来讲，这不是不合理的。
The younger son even confessed that he was no longer worthy to be called a son.
而且这个年这个小儿子自己也承认他自己不配成为他的儿子。
So why is the father doing all this?
但是为什么父亲还要这样做呢？
You know, 2 years ago, I was really sick.
两年前我生一场重病。
And because of my skin.
因为我的皮肤。
And it was really itchy and painful.
也很痒，而且很痛。
And I would have to leave work halfway through the day because it was so bad.
因为在我即使在工作的时候，我在半一半的时候我就要离开了，因为太痛了。
And I remember being bedridden and miserable as the days passed.
因为我仍然记得我躺在床上在痛苦当中的悲惨的情况。
And I could not attend meetings.
我不能够参加聚会。
I couldn't really do anything except maybe take a bath twice a day.
我们每天除了一天要洗两次澡之外，什么都做不了。
And I was waiting for my situation to pass.
我就等着我这个不好的情况能够过去。
I was feeling so sorry for myself in this powerless state.
我实在为我自己感到悲哀，我真的是在一个无助的情况里面。
I couldn't do anything.
我什么都做不了。
And my mind was occupied by what medicine to try or what remedy to try.
我的脑子里面满是想法，是我应该试哪个药呢？我们应该试哪个配方秘方呢？
And my mind was not occupied with the things of God.
我的心思里面没有被神所充满。
And so I was in this lost condition, waiting for my situation to pass.
当我在这样的境况，等待我这个悲惨的状况过去的时候。
And I began to question, does God even love a person like me?
我甚至有疑问说，神是不是要仍然爱像我这样的一个人
？Someone who's not useful to Him.
对他来讲我是毫无用处。
Someone who is sick.
对他来讲我是生病的。
And brothers and sisters, sometimes we fall into this trap.
很多时候我们好像就落在这样的网络的里面。
That as a good Christian, we should be doing something to favor curry with God.
我们作为一个基督徒，我们应该做一些事情来讨得神的喜悦。
We're told we should read the Bible every day and pray before every meal and go to church.
我们被教导说，我们要每天读圣经，我们在每一餐前要祷告，我们要来到教会聚会。
And if we do that, God will bless me.
如果我们做这些了，神就会祝福我们。
Brothers and sisters, these things are good and true.
但弟兄姊妹们，这些是好的事情，也是真实的。
But these things are just a response to God.
但是很多时候，这个不是神对我们的回应。
Thank God that these things don't earn us love from Him.
但是感谢主，我们这些事情不能够赢得神对我们的爱。
And this was something that the older son misunderstood about the very nature of his father and his relationship with them as sons.
这就是那个大儿子他认为心中所理解的他的父亲和儿子的关系。
He does not love his children any less because of what they have or have not done.
他我们的父这个父亲不会因为他的儿子做了什么而更多的爱他或者更少的爱他。
In Isaiah 64, it says that all our righteousness are like filthy rags.
我们以赛亚书里面特别的讲，我们所有的义就像那个这个破烂的衣裳。
But the father said to the older brother, "Son, you are always with me."
所以这个父亲对他的大儿子讲，儿子啊，你一直与我同在。
All I have is yours.
我所有的都是你的。
It was right that we should make merry and be glad.For your brother was dead and is alive again, and was lost and is found.
所以只是这个弟兄是死而复活，失而又得的，所以我们理当欢喜快乐。
This prodigal was not only lost but dead to his father.
这个比喻不仅是只是迷失了，而且是死了。
Isn't that a miracle?
这是一个神迹吗？
This once lost and worthless son has become somebody who has value.
但是他已经被遗失了，但是对他来讲，这个好像仍然有一个价值。
How do the dead become alive again?
如何死人能够又活了呢？
How does someone who has nothing or is nothing become something of worth to God?
如果一个人他不值任何事情，也没有任何的价值，在神的眼中，他是有价值的。
Psalm 8:5 says, "You have made him a little lower than angels." And you've crowned him with glory and honor.
在诗篇的八章五节中，你叫他比天使微小一点，并赐他荣耀尊贵为冠冕。
This is solely the doing of God.
这实在是神的作为。
The grace of God.
这是神的恩典。
Yet sometimes we think that before God we are so small.
在神的面前，很多时候我们觉得我们如此的渺小。
We are like worms or ants.
我们好像就是蚂蚁或者一个虫子。
We are these earthen vessels of clay that a potter has created.
我们好像就是属于那个属世的那个器皿，就是用木器、瓦器的。
And we're so fragile and easily broken at any given moment.
我们很脆弱，好像很多的时候我们随时都要破裂了。
And yet in us is the greatest treasure in the world.
但是在我们中间有世界上最大的宝藏。
We have the life of Christ in us.
我们在我们的心中有在我们里面有主耶稣在我们里面。
In 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 7, it says that we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that the excellence of the power may be of God and not of us.
哥林多后书四章七节讲，我们有这宝贝在瓦器里，要显明这莫大的能力是出于神，不是出于我们。
So why should the Son of Man come to seek and to save that which was lost?
为什么人子要来这里拯救失丧，寻找拯救失丧的？
Why is it necessary and needed?
这为什么这是必要的，而且是需要的？
Why should the shepherd seek out the lost and bring it back into the fold?
为什么这个牧人要去寻找那个迷失的羊，把它带回羊圈？
Why should the woman light a lamp and sweep the house until she has found the coin?
为何那个妇人她要点上灯打扫房子来寻找那个丢失的钱币呢？
Why should the father welcome the prodigal son back with open arms?
为什么那个父亲要把那个浪子欢迎那个浪子回来把他抱在怀中呢？
Put a ring on his finger, robe him, put sandals on his feet, and kill the fatted calf.
要把他戒指戴在他的手上，把袍子拿出来给他穿上，也把鞋穿在他的脚上，给他为他预备宴席。
Brothers and sisters, it is because we are so precious in his sight.
弟兄姊妹们，因为在他的眼中，我们是如此的宝贵。
Regardless of our lost condition and our attitude,
不管我们的境况是什么，我们的态度是什么，
the Lord brings us back to him because he loves us.
主把我们带回来，因为他爱我们。
For the prodigal, he is waiting with open arms to welcome him back without a word.
对于那个浪子来讲，他张开了双臂来迎接他。
For the older son, the father pleaded with him to enter and join him.
对于那个年长的大儿子讲，这个父亲恳求他和他们一起欢喜快乐。
For those that are his and belong to him.
对那些所有属他的人。
God does not see the imperfections of our sin and our human weaknesses in our bodies.
他不是看到我们在最终我们的不完美，我们在肉体里面的软弱。
God the Father looks at us and sees the value of Christ in us.
主看神看我们是看我们在我们的中间有他的宝贵的儿子成为至宝。
God sees the preciousness of Christ and his obedience even unto death on the cross.
神看他的儿子他完全的顺服，甚至死在十字架上，这是他心中的至宝。
And the fact of the matter is that God sees us as worthy, not because of anything we have or have done.
神看我们为宝贵，不是因为我们做了什么。
It is because we are in Christ and
因为我们在基督的里面。
And his completed work of salvation, that we are blessed with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ.
因为他所做的拯救，他赐给我们在他基督耶稣里面所有天上属灵的福气。
Jesus and not us.
耶稣不是我们
fully satisfies the requirements of our heavenly Father.
他完全满足了父神的要求。
The work of the cross brings pleasure to the Father and accomplishes His will.
这主耶稣在十字架上的工作，完成了父神的旨意，也让他得到心里面得满足。
This is right because we belong to Him.
这是正确的，因为我们属他。
That is our basic relationship that we belong to our Creator.
这是我们最基本的一个关系，我们属创造我们那位创造者。
As the clay belongs to the potter, so we belong to him.
就像泥土属于陶匠，我们也属于我们的主。
We as sheep belong to his fold.
我们是属于他羊圈里面的羊。
It is right because our God does not want us to be lost in the darkness.
因为我们的主在他不希望我们在黑暗中迷失了。
He doesn't want us to be lost on the path of destruction.
我们不要在毁坏的道路上，一直的走下去。
And he doesn't want us to be hidden, but be found in the light.
他不要我们隐藏，而是在光中我们被寻见。
It is right because we are his children.
因为他是我们是他的儿女。
We are valued and loved.
我们在他眼中为宝贵，我们被珍惜。
Because in him we find our worth.
因为在他的里面我们发现我们的价值。
Because there is this treasure.
因为这个宝贵。
The life of Christ in us.
因为这个宝贵的主耶稣在我们的里面。
So this morning I pray that we can be comforted by these words.
今天早上我就求神愿用这些话语来安慰我们。
We can remind ourselves of them.
再次的提醒我们。
And remind each other of them as well.
也彼此能够纪念。
Okay, let's pray.
我们一同祷告。
Dear Lord, we just want to look to you.
主啊，我们实在仰望你。
Well, we know that we belong to you and you belong to us.
我们知道我们属你，你也属我们。
And that you are seeking every heart here.
你就寻找我们每一个心。
And Lord, we just pray that we can humble ourselves and we can return to you.
我们实在求我们每一个人能够谦卑我们的心，返回到你的身边。
And if we are wandering far off, Lord, that we can come to you.
如果我们已经走远了，我们可以再次来到你的身边。
Because we know that your love is and compassion is greater than anything that can hinder us from coming to you.
因为你的爱，你的怜悯，不会阻挡我们，任何的阻挡，让我们不能够来到你的身边。
We just thank you for this morning and this time that we have to spend in your word.
我们感谢你今天早上你的同在，你所赐的话语。
In Jesus' name I pray.
奉主耶稣基督的名，阿门。
Amen. Amen.